Hey, what's poppin', everybody? Welcome back to Football Therapy with me, your host Jan. I do hope you lot are doing well, and welcome back to the channel and to today's video, which is a Chelsea news. Well, it's actually a transfer news video. Now, I know what you're saying. You're going, you know what, Jan? The transfer window shut, bro. We didn't sign anyone. Why are you making this video? Well, I'll tell you why, man. Because the transfer window did shut, but Chelsea have basically made a signing. They signed Hakim Ziyech, the agreement's there, both clubs have announced it, he's been talking about it ever since. Now, this has opened up a window of opportunity for Chelsea. Chelsea like to get business done early sometimes. It's weird, right? It's like if the window's open, they want to wait to deadline day. But if the deadline day's gone and the window's shut, they want to do business really early in between, put agreements in place, hence Hakim Ziyech and etc. And there are some news stories that are coming out recently that are interesting, and I would not be surprised if Chelsea did put another deal down before the transfer window to try and get an agreement in place to get ahead of the curve, because why not? This is happening now, apparently. So, there's three players I want to talk about. But before I do get into the good gear today, I want to remind you guys quickly to subscribe to Football Therapy. If you've not yet done so, remember we smashed through that 40k barrier, soaring like a beautiful eagle over the plains of YouTube, how well the channel is doing. So thank you so much for your support. Remember to subscribe, hit that bell notifications icon, like the video if you want to help me out, and also follow me on Instagram to hang out with me on Instagram Lives. All right then, let's get into it. So let's give you a heads up of what I'm talking about today. I want to talk about three players. The first off is Matias Vecino. Or I think it's Vecino, not Vecino. It's Vecino. I'm going to go with that for today's video. He is apparently being linked to Chelsea really heavily, and the deal is apparently close. The agreement is close, and this signing makes no sense to me. It made more sense to sign Milinkovic-Savic when we were linked to him, but generally Chelsea are flush for midfielders. I'm going to look at the news story and look at his numbers and speculate on that, but loads of heavy links are coming out recently, like heavy. So, it's a peculiar one. France Football have obviously released an article a couple of days ago, coming out pretty heavily, saying Chelsea have opened talks with Jadon Sancho, and they've gone from being the favourites to sign him to the second favourites when Manchester United became the favourites, but now Chelsea are the favourites again after this France Football article. But it does actually like look promising, and there, dare I say it, there's a feeling around the Chelsea fan base that this might actually be happening. Hakim Ziyech does not mean Chelsea do not sign Jadon Sancho, so yeah. And also a few news stories have come out recently trying to reinforce the link between Chelsea and Ben Chilwell. Apparently he does remain Frank Lampard's top target for left back. Karen Carney actually speculated his dip in form around January and just before came from his links to Chelsea, Manchester United and all that. But let's start on Vecino. So I'm going to quote to you what the Metro published about him, I think today or yesterday, the article. I think it's today. Chelsea have reportedly agreed, yeah, that seems pretty definitive, to meet Inter Milan's asking price for Matias Vecino in the summer. So again, the kind of story that was coming out about Ziyech before he signed or agreed, you know. Frank Lampard, who was less than impressed after Chelsea failed to make any immediate signings in January. I love how all these articles are saying the same thing. They're all prefaced with Lampard, who was really angry the other month, has told the clubs he wants to strengthen his squad as many as four new additions following Hakim Ziyech, so five in total, through the doors at the end of the season. The Blues will prioritise a move for midfielder 28-year-old Inter star Vecino, who's been identified as a realistic target for the season ahead 2021 campaign. According to the Daily Express, Chelsea are ready to pay up to €28 million, brackets £23 million, that Inter are demanding for the Uruguay international. So yeah, it goes on to talk about how Antonio Conte wants to sort of balance the books a little bit after all his purchases. Vecino came close to leaving in January to both United and Everton. And yeah, he's got loads of experience at 28. Right, so let me give you my opinion on this. I get how it's a realistic signing. Senior figure in the midfield, 28, although we've already got Jorginho's 28. Only £23 million. Obviously, that's incredibly cheap, especially with a player coming into the Premier League from Serie A. You know, you think they're trying to crank the price a little bit. But here's the thing, man. Chelsea don't need midfielders. Billy Gilmore's just been promoted to the first team. Ruben Loftus-Cheek's there. Mason Mount's there. Jorginho's there. Kovacic is there. Kante's there. Have I missed anyone? Oh, Reece James can play there. Ampadu can come back. Conor Gallagher can come back. It's a madness. Now, unless Chelsea are preparing for the exit of, say, Jorginho, I mean, I guess he could similar player profiles to Jorginho. I'm not sure what this story is. I mean, he's got 2 goals and 2 assists, but he's a central midfielder. He's not an attacking midfielder. So 2 goals, 2 assists in 13 appearances. Four goal contributions in 13 appearances. That's a goal contribution every 3 games-ish. Quite good for a central midfielder, to be honest. Takes 1.4 shots per game. He's got 2 man of the matches already this season, but it's still all pretty meh. Do you know what I mean? He's not that great defensively. He makes 1.8 tackles per game, which is decent, but he only makes 0.8 interceptions, which is pretty naff. I mean, what's that? That's 2.6 tackles and interceptions per game. It's all right. He does make 1.4 dribbles per game, which is pretty impressive. For me, it does look like a really good deal for a talented, generically good midfielder, £23 million for a player in his prime. But it just doesn't seem like we need him. Now, so the only thing I'm going to think of here is that Frank Lampard is like the midfielder's midfielder. Midfielder extraordinaire. He might see so much from his midfield that he wants to get in his team or like what he wants them to execute that he sees something in this guy and he's like, right, he can do exactly what I want, what I used to do or something. Because it does look like the link's very, very close. Unless he's like a Barkley replacement or a Jorginho replacement. But lest we forget, there's all those players I've talked about that are coming in, that are in the squad, so it's got me itching my head. Right, let's talk about Ben Chilwell. So Karen Carney did post an article recently. I'm not going to quote it to you, but she pretty much said Chilwell was really, really good. He then was bad over winter. She reckoned it's because his head was turned. One of those clubs include Chelsea. Now, this may be true. It left a lot of Chelsea fans in a weird place watching him over the winter because they were like, yeah, he's really, really good. He's probably like top 2-3 left-backs in the league with Andy Robertson, Luca Dean. Do you know what I mean? Who Chelsea have been linked with as well, but not very heavily. So I get it. And then his performance became really, really stinky. Obviously, he scored that goal against us, which was a good goal. But I don't know, man, for the money he'll cost, because I'm only speculating here, but I have a feeling Ben Chilwell will cost like £70 million. Do you know what I mean? Sure, Chelsea fans talk about Telles and Grimaldo and other like world-class left-backs around Europe, but if Frank Lampard has a player profile that he wants and Ben Chilwell fits it, great. But I just feel a little bit like, is he really worth the money? Because I feel like he should probably cost £40 million. Do you know what I mean? It is interesting. Maybe he feels like he can see what he does in the Premier League. I want him to continue doing that in the Premier League, but for my Chelsea side, and he can do this particular thing that I want that will work really, really well. He's going to have team synergy with other England teammates on the pitch. I want to do this. Fine. I think every Chelsea fan would be excited with the signing of Ben Chilwell. It would be a huge signing, but your sort of pragmatic, like, football manager, inner football manager would be like, does this make sense entirely? Should we be spending this money elsewhere? And also, with all this stuff that's going on with Manchester City, you get nervous, but you'd hope Chelsea would have the finances tightened up, proper wrapped up. I know it's in the 3-year cycles, financial fair play. Chelsea haven't spent, they've earned, da 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 da. So you'd hope they'd be extra careful, especially after being in trouble with UEFA before and all that. But I don't, who knows, maybe Chelsea signed him for £50 million and he's really, really good and everything's fine. Anyway, watch this space. We'll keep talking about that as the news comes out. All right, finally, let's talk about Jadon Sancho because the hype is real, man. There's no slowing down on this hype train. BR Football, you know, put on their Instagram that graphic of him with going like this with his Dortmund shirt, looking up at a Chelsea shirt, and there's bubbling up under the surface that Jadon Sancho's going to Chelsea. He's been heavily touted to return to the Premier League. Manchester City was one of the potential suitors, even though I maintained I thought he wouldn't go back. But after all this stuff recently, I think you could just say no, he's not going to Manchester City. So it's Manchester United and Chelsea who are favourites, and of course, Liverpool. Now, although we know he's a Chelsea fan, he's mates with Hudson-Odoi and Tammy, idolised Lampard and all this romantic football stuff, he's got to think about his career, man. And if Liverpool came knocking and he didn't particularly have any allegiance with Chelsea in terms of his professional career, he might just go, oh man, I'm going to Liverpool. They don't ever lose. They're champions of Europe. They're winning the Premier League. I can just win loads of titles so early in my career. And you'd think Liverpool would have the money at this point. They haven't really spent that big recently. They're winning loads. Their revenue is going up and up and up. They won't have any problems with financial fair play. So Liverpool could be a massive, massive option for Jadon Sancho. He'd have to trust his ability to break into that front three though and dislodge either Mane or Salah, which in terms of his own personal talent, you might think, yeah, he could do that. He's an absolute superstar and he's really young. But to be honest, it's not as easy as that. Liverpool's front three is like a matter of like team synergy. Do you know what I mean? Like, look at Mane coming on the last game to get the winner. When one of them's missing, you can tell. When Firmino's not on, everything breaks down. Like, there's something so, so important about that team synergy. So would they want to break that down for Jadon Sancho, or would he sit on the bench for a while? He wouldn't have that, let's be real. So he might go to Liverpool, but for theoretical sake, let's say he won't for those reasons. It is between Manchester United and Chelsea. Chelsea were long being favourites because they need to replace Hazard and they hadn't spent, and he came out saying he was a Chelsea fan. But then Chelsea bought Ziyech. Man United apparently have got a really close relationship with Dortmund, sent loads of representatives over, and apparently the bookies made United favourites over Chelsea again, until France Football recently published this article and said, no, Chelsea have already opened talks with Dortmund about signing Sancho and might even try and get an agreement over the line like they did with Ziyech before the summer. But Dortmund apparently want to wait till after the Euros to try and crank up his price. Understandably, it's all about the money. So what do I think? I would bloody love Jadon Sancho to come to Chelsea. Of course, man, everyone would. I mean, I've voiced on this channel before, I do have concerns of fitting everyone in. Ziyech, Pulisic, Hudson-Odoi, Sancho, and that's if both Willian and Pedro go. We pretty much know Pedro's going, but Willian goes as well. Then you've got four elite wingers, and I do put Hudson-Odoi in that bracket because I think he's very talented. Four elite wingers. How do you keep them all happy when only 50% of those wingers can start? It's a very difficult one. But if Chelsea want to go for that, you know, and be like, we're big boys, we want to have this problem, then fair play. If you can keep everyone happy, then, you know, good on you. Play Ziyech in the 10, maybe in a 4-2-3-1. Then you can get three of the four starting at once. I don't know, man. But France Football say Chelsea are in open talks. Chelsea are sort of bumping as favourites again. I don't want to get too excited. I mean, if Chelsea don't sign Sancho and they sign a few other players, it will still be really good business with Ziyech leading the line. But there's a very real chance they might sign Jadon Sancho. Anyway, what do you guys think? Get down in the comments below. Comment on all the players I've spoken about today. Sancho, Chilwell, and Vecino, which is still blows my mind. Let me know your thoughts and opinions on it. Get down in the comment section below. If you've enjoyed the content today, guys, please do like the video. That means a lot to me. Remember to subscribe if you are indeed new to the channel, and follow me on social media at FootballYannick on both Twitter and Instagram. Well, that's it from me, guys. You lot enjoy the football, and I will see you later. You ain't so tough with that bad boy tuck. I'ma get it how I'm living, I'ma walk the walk. Outline my lines, I rap through thought. Body bag the verse, outline the chalk. In my life seen trouble, hustle on the double. Silence on the trigger like my pick got a muzzle. Yo chick like to guzzle, bad boy stay in trouble. I only love this paper, sorry I don't. I love me baby.